Please come up with me at this stage.
Small and medium-sized enterprises. So coming towards the literature review,
which we can see is the economic growth of our country basically depends on services sectors, manufacturing sector, where I already said that 40% share is like contributed from SMEs. So we can't like override the unhidden or untapped potential of this SME growth in for our country. So we can already see that SME Bank has already stated that SMEs actually play a speeding up role for the industrial development, in which they actually link the rural zones of the country with the broadened and the structured urban zones of Pakistan, so that SMEs can actually contribute to the overall pie of the contribution for economic growth. So we can utilize the benefits through the research is already done by the State Bank of Pakistan and the Government of Pakistan, where they have put a lot of effort so that SME culture and their growth can be cultivated for the country. So SME sector in Pakistan actually has, you know, drive for the entrepreneurial and managerial and labor skills enhancement, and through which they can actually provide better customer services, and they can go for innovative productivity and enhanced availability to meet the needs of ever-changing needs of the customer. So with the event and the I would not say the invasion of CPEC, I would rather say the symbiotic relationship between the two countries through this CPEC corridor, we can see that there would be high level confusion values which would be interjected into like our country and the management and the processes which would be taking place in the years like till 2030 coming in front of us. So we can now put some light on the role of SMEs, which they can contribute to the Pakistan, which actually requires them to bring transformational change and being very receptive to accept the change, for accepting the external values of the Chinese culture, Confucianism, so that they can build and they can enhance their better structures and they can move towards the growth period. So we already seen that there are a lot of differences in the perceptions of Chinese and in the perceptions of Pakistanis, and we have already seen that the Confucian cultural values differ a lot in both the countries in terms of uncertainty avoidance, in terms of like short-term or long-term orientation, where Chinese are actually long-term oriented and we are actually short-term oriented. They like, we like power distance autonomy, and they have some different implications, and we can also see a big difference in the uncertainty avoidance thing. So the cultural context of Pakistan therefore emphasizes the professionals of our host country, which would be, you know, taking the maximum advantage out of CPEC from China, so that we need some educated people, we need some competitive people, and we need some like strategic thinkers, that they can move their potential towards the global growth for the Pakistan. So as we have seen that there is a collectivist culture, collectivism based culture in Pakistan, which actually hinders the capabilities of the people to accept some change, or maybe to like exchange the loyalty, which is actually a very important cultural implication, so that it actually hinders their capability to work in under the supervision of some other foreigners like Chinese. So we can see that they are managers of host country are actually short-term oriented, and it prevents them to take risks, and like they have some inhibitions in due to having some like traditional based norms or precedent norms. So we are not going to like accept those norms. And for especially the large scale and the small scale organizations to be successful in this intense globalized world, we need to have very developed, very competent human resource, and as well as so that we can actually adjust ourselves to the changing environment and the changing culture which would be brought in or injected by the Chinese. So now we can come towards the role of CPEC and its commencement, this huge game changer corridor for the Pakistan, where we have more than like 50% share of them. So we can see that now organizations, especially the SMEs, are employing Pakistanis as well as Chinese into the organization so that they can work together. And we can have a very good example, as I have shared, that according to the Express Tribune's, 25% of the people would now be employed as Chinese, and 75% of the share would be given by the human resource of Pakistan. So we can see through this clear statistics and these clear 75 and 25% change in the employment share, we can see that Chinese culture has been brought into the organization territories of our country. So which now like gives us a clear view that there would be very strong cultural influences on the people which would be working, especially the Pakistani nationals, the host nationals of the country and SMEs. So we can see that now Pakistani people who were actually not like very hard workers, very committed with their work, now being working under the authority of Chinese or the, with the commencement or interjection of Chinese culture, now Pakistani employees will have to become more work hard working, they will have to become more committed towards the work, and they will have to, you know, because they used to live a life without worrying to hard work, now they will have to change their thinking to live a life with a very strong intention to work hard. So now we can see that the divergent set of values existing in both Pakistani and Chinese cultures regarding the ethical implications and more inclination towards the hard work has created a big challenge for Pakistani employees that will be working for SMEs, because we have some different cultural norms and values as Chinese do have. So one of the critical issues regarding the work ethic implications would be like Pakistanis cannot always be trusted for their transactions due to uneven exhibition of the wealth. We can see a clear difference even in the provinces of our very same country. Like we can see that people in Punjab lack commitment, and they have like an ability to put the work into the queues. Rather, people living in Karachi, they do trust, they do have more trust on the people working in small businesses. So we can see a difference within the provinces of our same country, that is Pakistan. So how can we like see to bring harmony with the two nations and two different divergent cultures? So I would like to add that CPEC actually would be very optimistic, fruitful, and a very profitable corridor for the country and SME sector, due to the reason the Chinese will follow a non-Asian approach, and this would actually inhibit the bias and the disdain behaviors of the which can be avoided by the Chinese contrary to the Western value system. So yet Pakistani workers and SMEs will be bound to work under the strict rules and time limits, but discipline will change the picture of the country. So people would be now very much time bound and punctual as they were not actually before. So resultantly we can see that as a conclusion, the institutionalization of ancillary venture projects in Pakistan will become an important source of SME sector emergence, as well as giving boost to economic development and growth. So, and we can see a silver lining that is clearly visible in the sky, that industrial development through China-Pakistan corridor aims not only to open new avenues for the trade, as well as it attracts huge investments, and so that we can gain strong economic and growth outcomes for the industry and SME. So we can also find an unlimited potential in our human resource that can be trained well, and that can be given a more opportunity to work for SME sector for the boost and capitalization of the SME sector of the country. So we need to be very action oriented and implementation oriented, so that we cannot be confined to the documentation, rather action is more important. So this was all from my side.